In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Dear friends, tonight we celebrate the Requiem Mass for a very young priest by the name of Father Kenneth Walker, a priest of the Fraternity of St. Peter, who died tragically last week in an incident that we can only find to be terrible and tragic. But as we come here to this celebration, and I use the word celebration in quotation marks, we celebrate the Requiem Mass in a tone that is both serious and piercing. The Divine Liturgy of the Extraordinary Four, which Father Walker celebrated every day of his young priesthood, is for us an education and a celebration of our holy Catholic faith. As we contemplate the tragedy that befell this young priest, I am reminded of those words of St. John of the Cross, who, upon hearing of the death of a young priest, asked the one who told him, "How many masses did he say?" And the saint was told, the young priest offered 5 masses before he died. And St. John of the Cross said, "He will have much to answer for." In the light of the saints, the celebration of the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass is such a tremendous responsibility that this pearl of great price that has been bestowed upon mere creatures, mortals, full of sin, is such an awesome responsibility that though those who have much been given, much will be expected. And so we offer this holy sacrifice of the Mass as a suffrage for the soul of Father Kenneth Walker and for all priests, because we know before the face of God, no man is without sin. And so the offering of the Holy Mass then becomes a great purification, a great fire from on high to cleanse the soul after death. We believe as Catholics that God is not a magician, that God does not come and simply wipe away our sins, but rather, his saving work, which is for all men, is made efficient by our own correspondence. And that each person must take upon themselves the responsibility of applying the merits of the passion, death, and resurrection of our blessed Lord upon their soul. And if we fail to do that, that is our own fault. And we're as if God is appealing to us through the death of this young priest to remind us and to teach us that life is short and death is certain, and no one knows the hour of their death. And so we must prepare for that coming judgment. Prepare by doing penance in our own life. We believe that even one mortal sin merits hell. And even if we have only committed one mortal sin in our entire life, that one mortal sin constitutes damnation. And so when we contemplate that we have been forgiven our mortal sins in the great tribunal of God's mercy, in the sacrament of confession, we rejoice with the angels and we feel resplendently free. But even though that sin has been absolved, even though that sin has been forgiven, we must not pass too lightly over the fact that we have merited hell by our sin. And that is why we must try to appropriate to ourselves and apply to our soul the merits of the Lord by penance. By offering to our Lord a sweet and fragrant offering, so that we might be able in some way to repair the brokenness of our relationship with the Lord. Our Lord is not a magician. He will not magically make our sins all disappear. He respects our freedom all too much. And he desires that we live in his friendship every day of our life. And that is why the holy sacrifice of the Mass then becomes this propitiatory sacrifice. It becomes the offering for those who can no longer offer. It becomes the help for those who can no longer do penance. It becomes that sweet balm for those so conscious of their weakness, who count upon the church militant to offer for them this heavenly grace. And might we say then too, that the death of this young priest is an occasion also for us to consider that as our blessed Lord comes down upon this altar in the consecration of the host and of the chalice, that he seeks amongst us to form us into becoming victims with him for sin. And that each of us in our own way, joined to the great high priest, become victims for the sins of the world. This young priest, who daily went before the face of the Father to offer the divine sacrifice, no doubt had very well instilled in him that understanding that when we consume the body and blood of the Lord, we become one with the divine victim, offering ourselves for the salvation of the world. And we might say that the Lord was so pleased with this young priest's offering that he manifested it by giving this young priest a young and early death, so that he might be more joined and configured more perfectly to Christ the great high priest as a victim for sin. And do we need to enunciate and enumerate the numerous sins of the priesthood that have need of victim priests and living sacrifices? We do not want to mar this celebration by speaking of such things, except to say that, Lord, we wish in our own way to become victims with you upon this altar, in this age which has so glamorized the notion of victim. We know that you, O Lord, are the only true victim, and that only you offer the redeeming sacrifice that takes away sin and restores the broken relationship between man and God. But we, in our own little way, offer ourselves with you and for you, with your servant, Father Kenneth Walker, that we might be able to win for our contemporaries the graces of conversion that are offered to us in the heart of Jesus Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.